Sony A7R Mark III. I just bought this camera and I want to tell you my impressions as a heavy Fujifilm user. Hi there, my name is Tudor Matescu and on this channel we talk about photography tips and gear and so on. So please subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. So let's get to the subject. I'm a heavy Fujifilm user. I've bought my first X100 Finepix camera 7-8 years ago. This is X100V. Please check the video that I made about X100V. There are two videos about X100V and will follow more. And I've bought this A7R Mark III because as a heavy Fujifilm user that it's limited to an APS-C sensor, I was curious about a full frame camera. I had before Sony A7S, so this is why I have the lenses for the Sony system, but I didn't have at least a 24 megapixel full frame camera. At the time when I bought Sony A7S, the camera 12 megapixel was sufficient for me years ago because Fujifilm Finepix X100 had 12 megapixels. But as the year passed by, 12 megapixel didn't suit me anymore. And I've remained with full frame lenses and with a body with 12 megapixels. And because of the bad ergonomics of Sony A7S, I didn't use that camera and I started to sell some of the lenses. But a good offer came and I've bought now Sony A7R Mark III. And now I want to tell you my impressions. First, the sensor. 42 megapixels or 47 megapixels, doesn't matter. So 40 plus megapixels. Extraordinary resolution, extraordinary sharpness, extraordinary detail. And for a black and white heavy passionate user like I am, extraordinary dynamic range, extraordinary tones that you can feel in the photography that you are making with this camera. So it really feels that sensor, it really shines with the 42 megapixel that this sensor has it. So it is very sharp, it is very detailed. And I think that the Sony system is very accessible now, comparing to Nikon Z7 or Leica cameras. So the problems, the big problems that we Fujifilm users have is the ergonomics of the camera. Is the camera too big? Is the camera too heavy? Does the camera have good ergonomics and good colors? And I want to talk about this too. So what it impressed me above the detailed images that I get and the beautiful black and white images that I get, and in this video I will show some photos made with this camera. So what impressed me is the ergonomics. The camera has it. This camera really has the ergonomics. I don't feel I'm losing the Fujifilm ergonomics. Yes, the menus are a little tough to learn, but we are technical people. This is not a problem for us. For young people that are using cameras, that are doing content creation and activities and so on. So this is not a problem. You will learn the menus, come on. It doesn't matter. It is a full frame camera with an autofocusing system. It's amazing. It's amazing, the eye autofocusing system. It's something that I never think it would be possible. I have IF on Fujifilm and I thought it was good. I knew it wasn't so good. But Sony autofocusing system IAF, it's amazing. So, the ergonomics. You can customize this camera like a Fujifilm camera. Yes, it's like an X-T4 or X-T3 because it has the tilting screen, no, not the flippy screen. And I love a tilting screen, EVF. Amazing. The screen, it's okay. It has a compensation dial, very sturdy, like on Fuji X100V. With this lens, a pancake lens, very small and light, you have a very, very competent camera. And it really feels good in the hand. I don't feel what I felt when I hold Sony A7S. Sony A7S, I really didn't like it in the hand. Even if this camera is heavier than Sony A7S, than Fujifilm X-T4, than Fujifilm X-Pro3, the weight of this camera is very well distributed. So you don't feel like you have a heavy camera in your hand. No, you feel you have a sturdy camera in your hand. The grip, fantastic. The texture, fantastic. The buttons, the layout, everything, it's fantastic. I really feel premium quality, not just a premium sensor. Talking about the weight, here is a Zorki camera with film in it. I feel it a little heavier than Sony A7R Mark III. But this heavy thing, this sturdy thing that you feel in your head, it's something that it really makes you tick. It's really giving you the mojo. It is important not to have a very lightly camera, but sometimes you want a more sturdy camera. So Sony A7 Mark III, it ticks this box. Yes, it is a camera that you can take it with you every day with the small pancake lenses from Sony and from Samyang and Tamron. So this is very important. You will have a 42 megapixel camera with excellent IAF, with excellent ergonomics, with excellent small pancake lenses, having full frame quality. So now the problem that we Fujifilm user, it is possible to have with this camera, it's the color science. What we like, or what I really like about Fujifilm, it's the, not the color science, but the film simulation recipes and the film simulation profiles that I have in Fujifilm. But I use Adobe Lightroom and I'm a heavy black and white fan. So I edit my photography in black and white, and I especially use silver effects. Sometimes I get the results that I want straight from the camera, but I always use the RAW files. So for me, Sony A7 Mark III has a sense in this area, because I will use the RAW files. When you have a 42 megapixel camera, it is crazy not to use the RAW files to get what you want from that RAW files. Also, Sony has some options that you can customize your JPEGs, so you can make them more contrasty, more punchy, you can shift the white balance, you can do all kind of stuff. So I almost obtained the color chrome JPEG profile on this camera, and the black and white that are coming from this camera, I really, really love. So it's not something that I can't use. I really do love the JPEG files from Sony cameras, but yes, they don't have the filmish look, the filmy simulation from the Fujifilm files. But it's something that I can bypass because I edit my files, so I can control the output of the files. In Capture One, we can select the profile of a Fujifilm camera and apply it to a Sony camera, to a Sony RAW file. So I will be there with the color from Fuji. But I do must agree that the Fujifilm JPEGs are shining, so we can't match them. But I really do need the color science of Fujifilm in my portfolio, or I want to have my own color science, my own black and white style. And because I want my own color style, I can use very easily Sony. For who is this camera? This is another factor that is very important. Lots of YouTubers talked about that Sony are their workhorse and they are using Fujifilm for fun family photography, street photography shoots. But I think that this camera can deliver in all situations. That it can be a family camera, it can be a street photography camera, it can be a wedding photography camera, it can be a studio photography camera. And this is huge. Also the shutter mechanism, it's 50,000 guaranteed. It has a lot of features that I will talk in another video. But what I want to point is that this camera can be used in all the situation that you want to use it. It's not a camera that you can say it's a little big, I will not take it. Fujifilm X-T4, it's big. Fujifilm X-Pro3, as you know, I use it and I'm using that camera, it's big. There are cameras that are needed to be packed in a camera bag. So this camera enters in the same camera bag that I'm using for Fujifilm X-Pro3 and for Fujifilm X100V, and I don't feel it's weighter, I don't feel I'm losing the ergonomics. I'm feeling I'm gaining good ergonomics, better AF, and better image quality. And this is really important. I don't think I will take this camera every day. Of course, every day camera, an easier camera, it's X100V. And why I will still use X100V and Fujifilm system is for my family pictures or for documentary work, because that JPEGs that I don't want to edit, let's say I want to make a video and I don't want to stay to edit all the photos that I need, and I need that photos fast, it is easier with Fujifilm. Yes, for family pictures I don't want to edit RAW files, and that's why I will use Fujifilm X100V. But if I will get a good profile in camera on Sony, I will use it. For black and white, I really love what I get. I really love what I get from black and white JPEGs files from Fuji. And I really found some profiles that are suitable for family shootings or street colored photography. And I guess when the time will pass and I will learn more about this camera, I will be able to get some good JPEGs files straight from the camera, because we have the options to shift the white balance, to adjust the contrast, to adjust the sharpness, and so on. So and saturation, and there are lots of profiles and recipes for Sony also, so it is possible to get good JPEGs files from this camera. Also, their profiles are Sony profiles, I agree with that, but they are not bad. Some people like it, some people don't. I especially like Fujifilm colors, of course, but I can't say the colors from JPEGs files from a Sony camera are bad. They are not bad. They have their own personality, their own signature, like every camera system on the market. So for me, this camera really, really complements the Fujifilm system. Also the batteries. What a beautiful big battery, and this battery kept me 2 days of shooting, 2.5 days of heavy shooting. It is amazing. I really don't get that duration of life from a Fujifilm battery. So I'm really amazed with the quality and amazed with the price. Yes, the price is a little bit more than a Fujifilm camera, but you get 10 times more. You get the autofocusing system, it's 10 times better. The image quality from the RAW files, what you have there, it's 10 times better. So you really do invest in your photography with this camera, so you will have good image files that are able to show good printing results and to look very good on a big screen. And this is very important also. I can do huge banners with this camera. It is amazing. In conclusion, as a passionate street photographer, I really do think this camera can be used very well for street photography. And we have some good example on Instagram of a very good photographer that is using Sony system. And there are more that are using the Sony system for street photography and they are having great results. It's not the camera, it's not the camera. But what it is important, it is this camera can be used on street photography missions for documentary work and for all kind of photography work. It's not just a workhorse camera for studio photography or for wedding photography. It's a camera that can be used for fun. Take a look at this camera and think about it. The full frame quality is something that I really like and I really love, and I have it on this camera. I don't want full frame quality every time, but when I want a more organic looking photography, like the film photography that I was used to, I can go to Fujifilm. Either way, the problem is not choosing Sony or Fujifilm. They are complementary systems from my point of view. And for an APS-C body, I really will go with Fujifilm and on full frame with Sony and also Nikon mirrorless cameras, but they are just at a starting point. Well, for now, it is Sony. It is a really good, very good camera, very competent camera. It can be your only camera because you can do street photography with it. You can do wedding photography. You can do studio photography. You can do all kinds of photography, low light photography, and so on, that you will not be able to do with Fujifilm. You can get great results and you can publish banners, big banners, with this camera, advertising banners. So it is a very capable camera. So if you want just one camera, one system to invest, my advice is go with Sony, because you will have small lenses, Samyang, Tamron, and Sony Pancake lenses, accessible prices, look at the prices, accessible weight, and you can do all kind of photography and vlogging and videography with this camera. Unfortunately, you can't do all with a Fujifilm system. You can do it, but this is better. It really is better. So for professional shoots, I recommend this. Just for hobby and fun, if you just starting photography, you can go with Fujifilm. But if you know you want to go professionally, you want to be paid, you want to get all kinds of professionally paid photography jobs, it is better to go with Sony. Tell me what you think in the comments. Please subscribe to my channel and talk to you soon. Bye bye.